Hello and welcome to Polymer Update. This is Shanshari Banerjee and joining me today is Mr. Tamo Rotsep, Senior Vice President Asia South Bharuj. We welcome you, sir, on Polymer Update.
Thank you very much. Nice to be here.
So, sir, Bharuj has been in the Indian market for almost 2 decades now. So how has it helped in boosting the sustainable progress of the Indian plastics industry?
Actually, we are very proud of being part of Indian market and growth of the India. We have been already, like you mentioned, 2 decades here. We have our own team and we have been also working together with our customers. The aim for us in Bharuj is to have some products which can make also life of our customers and their customers better.
So Bharuj has recently introduced Anteo to customers in New Delhi. How exactly does it add value to the customers?
Anteo is a very good example of innovation. We are very strong in advanced packaging when it comes both rigid and flexible packaging. And Anteo is one of our latest innovation which we are introducing into the market, wherein film customers, they can really see improvement when it comes to the processing, sealability and really to increase the efficiency.
Talking about innovation and technology in today's scenario, what do you think, what role does technology play in the Indian industry?
I think innovation is a key because again, you have to compare yourself in India together with markets nearby. And at the end, you have to compete in a global world marketplace. And innovation is one way how to achieve it. And that's why we in Bharuj also have a look, how can we offer you innovative product, differentiated solutions, which can also make your competitive much more stronger.
How according to you is innovation shaping the markets?
Especially when we look in India, where is a very big growth when it's infrastructure markets, in packaging markets, there are specific needs for products which can really perform much better than they were performing yesterday. And that's where it comes into the play, the advanced machinery, but also at very advanced materials, which can really give you the competitive edge.
So do you think are there any barriers that exist in innovation products and technologies?
In innovation, always it takes somebody to be brave and somebody to be the first, to try out something new that has not been done before. And that's why it's very good when you can cooperate with somebody who have experience in one area, your other partner has experience in other area. Together you can really make things, different solutions working out and benefit out of that.
Now shifting our focus to the auto and FMCG sectors in India, there's a driving demand for propylene in India. So what specific steps are being taken by Bharuj to cope with this current scenario?
In polypropylene market, we have been already years and we have quite advanced product portfolio where can we really help our customers to achieve better product and processing efficiencies. We have been providing solutions and it's supporting the growth both in agricultural sector, in packaging sector, infrastructure sector. So all of these areas, they are really important to see the growth and really to get the benefit out of the advanced solutions.
How is Bharuj contributing to the boost of the agricultural sector in India?
Agriculture sector is really one of the cornerstone we will look the Indian economy, and really to have a growth in this sector requires quite advanced farming techniques. It requires irrigation systems. It requires different way of handling things than we did it today yesterday. And here we can also share some of our knowledge and our quite advanced products which are available. One of the examples is that the film products with the diffused light where Bharuj can really show the difference, the crop yield, also our solutions in irrigation or in mulch film market, something where we can see our products where we have really tangible benefits achieved by our customers.
Do you think the Indian plastics industry has the potential to grow?
I think it's enormous growth potential in Indian plastics industry. There is one thing which also we have to look into and to see how can we increase not only plastic industry but also the circular economy. Also how can we contribute to the economy taking care of the plastics after the life cycle, recycling, collecting and using it again. because that's also part of our industry responsibility.
So with the Make in India initiative coming into play, do you think India is heading towards becoming one of the biggest innovation hubs?
I think India has all the right ingredients to make it happen. Smart people, advanced technology hubs, and willingness to get things done. And that's why really we are very happy to be part of this journey together with Indian customers and to their customers as well.
There was also GST that was passed in July last year. It's been 7 months since the implementation of the goods and services tax. So how, according to you, has it affected the manufacturing business of the Indian plastics industry?
I think this is a very good example where India as a country has taken a very bold step. Of course, these kind of new initiatives and new solutions, they will create some disturbance in the market in the short term. People also will struggle to get it implemented. But once it is done, it will open up a lot of new potential, and really it will open up India as a one big market for the all participants.
So, talking about growth opportunities, we are at Plast India. So how has Plast India been a platform for Bharuch for creating value for plastics in the Indian industry?
In our industry, it's very important that you put all three M's together: machine, men and materials. And that's what we see also here in Plast India. There are also advanced materials used with the newest machines, and at the end people could put all it together.
Thank you so much, sir, for joining us on Polymer Update. With camera person Venkatesh Bakle, this is Shanchari Banerjee for Polymer Update.